Hello, hello. My name is Double Plus. I'm good. I'm going to be doing something a little bit different today. I thought I would give a try doing taking some of my builds that I've written in Imgur guides out for a spin in Gloomhaven Digital. I'm calling this little episode Melee Summon Madness because I want to show off how to play a melee summoner focused party at a higher level. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be playing at plus two difficulty with three level seven characters, so that'll get me up to difficulty six. Honestly, I would really like to do this at plus three because I think this party could definitely handle it, but especially in Gloomhaven Digital, but I didn't get the mod on this save, and it's a little tricky to update the difficulty, so we're going to be doing it at plus two instead of plus three. The three classes I'm going to be playing are the Tinker. I'm going to be using my Tinkerbot Commander build. I'm going to update it a little bit though because it's one of my older guides. I'm going to be using my Mindthief Ice Queen build, and then I'm going to be using my, spoiler alert, two minis, Beast Tyrant Totem Warrior build. I'll include links to those in the comments below. And I'll flag some of the differences and some of the card choices I've made that are different so that these guys can gel together a little bit better. So anyway, I've already got a scenario pulled up. So let's just go hop in and see what we got. So when we load this thing up, I'm going to show the cards. I won't talk through them all super in deep matter. You guys can look at the Imgur guides for that, but I'll flag some of the differences, some of the item choices, and some of the enhancements I've made, just so you can see some of the thinking I've had. We've been discovered, but no matter. Okay, so here is our tyrant. This follows my guide pretty closely, but instead of taking the wind totem at level 7, I've instead taken Tyrannical Force, the stun. I'm using that in addition to Earth and Spike so that we can have a lot more CC. And really, like, that's something I want to flag early on. I think the one of the big strengths of this particular trio is that they have a lot of crowd control among them. They have so many stuns, disarms, and immobilizes. They can really keep enemies locked down for quite a while if they want to. And we're going to lean into that with all three characters. For the Mind Thief, this is basically just the Ice Queen build. I don't think there's anything super different here that I want to flag for you. And the Tinkerer, again, the Tinkerbot Commander build, but one thing I want to flag is that I have taken Hook Gun. I think Hook Gun is it's a card I slagged on a lot in that build. It was my first ever guide. I've really come around on it. I think it's actually a pretty important card for the Tinkerer. Tinkerer really cares about positioning, so you want to bring this card along to help him get the most out of his AoEs and other abilities. For items, I'll start again with the Tinkerer. Well, actually, let's go back to the Tyrant. So the Tyrant is going to be wearing the Cloak of Invisibility. This is really almost exclusively for using the door trick, which I'll show off a little bit later probably, but might get him out of trouble later. We've got the net shoot, the weighted net, that will help add some CC if we need it. We probably won't, but it's always good to have just in case. We have some healing potions, which will go well with Borrowed Essence. If we want to give some health to the bear, we want to be able to get that back. And we have a mana potion, which we can either use to support ourselves, or maybe get a really awesome, wind and earth hit from Borrowed Essence, or we can use it to support the Mind Thief. Mind Thief, we have the long spear. It's a really good item if you can get that lineup to get the double stun from Frozen Mind. We have a stun powder, and again, a free stun, always good to have. Mana potion again, just in case we need to generate some ice. Or for ourselves, or maybe some earth or air for the Beast Tyrant. And then we have this Moon Earring, which is going to help us with our Boots of Striding and our Long Spear in case we need to re-up those. Oh, I should mention again on the Tyrant, Boots of Speed, super important boots. Really, really great for a summoning class. Honestly, I'd have it on all three classes, characters in this scenario, but we only have two in the shop, so we're just going to have it on the Tyrant and the Tinkerer. But it's really great because with Summoner, sometimes you need to be able to go just a little bit faster or even a little bit slower. It can make it a big difference if you're trying to beat a enemy who's about to activate a retaliate ability and other things like that. With the Tinkerer, I would probably have put the invisibility cloak on the Tinkerer again if there were more than two in the shop, but they're not, so I gave him a cloak of pockets instead. By the way, I'm kind of playing around as if I had Prosperity 3 shop. That's not quite the way that digital works, but I want to try to keep this at a relatively spoiler low spoiler environment. So we're keeping only items that would have been available in the Gloomhaven Prosperity 3 shop. Cloak of Pockets is a Prosperity 2 item, so that lets us have a bunch more items. So we've stacked up a lot of potions and stun powder again. We have the Empowering Talisman, really almost exclusively so that we can either use the Stun Powder or the Doomed Compass. That's not a prospect. That's like a sort of bonus item that I'm going to throw in here because I just love it on the Tinkerer. The Tinkerer, again, loves positioning. So Doomed Compass is a great item, especially for the Tinkerer. So we're going to be using probably this Empowering Talisman either on the Doomed Compass or the Stun Powder. Finally, we have Enhancements. I've given each of these classes like 100-ish gold spending around money for enhancements. I figure this is kind of an amount that people could probably afford in a typical campaign. Like, I'm not going to go for any crazy, like, 500 gold enhancements. With the Tyrant, what I've done is I've added some range to Earthen Spikes, which really helps make this card work. Range 2 is challenging to work with. Range 3 makes all the difference in the world. It's pretty cheap, too. It's like 55 gold, so definitely worth picking up. And I've also added a jump to Relentless Ally, which just makes it, again, kind of a quality of life improvement. It makes it easier to get in a position to summon things where you want them to be. With the Mindthief, I have done exactly one enhancement, and that is to add a movement to the Plague Rat, kind of similar to range. One movement to summon is difficult to work with. Movement 2 is much easier. And so this is a pretty big quality of life improvement for the summon. Makes it useful into higher levels. And then finally with the Tinkerer, again, we've added a jump to Ink Bomb, quality of life. And then the Hook a Gun, I've actually added some range. Again, I've come around on Hook a Gun a lot, and I like adding range to this because what happens is if you pull an enemy that has Retaliate, like this guard captain over here, and you pull them next to you, that Retaliate will activate. But if you have a range 4, pull 2, you can kind of pull him towards you without activating that Retaliate. And also, just range 4 makes it easier to get away with doing some pulls. So, that about covers it for this squad. Let's go ahead and jump into the scenario, see what we can do. This is actually a really easy room. Kind of shocked at how easy it is. Two enemies for a three-person party is very low. Digital can kind of serve up some easier scenarios sometimes. It looks like it is a big scenario, though. We've got five rooms, so could be that we're going to be seeing more enemies going forward. The loadout for this scenario has the guards, we have the archers, we have the artillery. It's the Operation Unlock scenario you can see over here. I think we also have some harrowers in here that are going to be a big pain for our summons because we don't like retaliates. So what we're going to do here, the biggest problem in this room for us is this guard, this elite guard. He's got the innate shield and innate retaliate, which is just going to chew through our summons if they go after him. So this is kind of a guy that the summoners are going to want to take care of. This artillery, on the other hand, is something that our summons can definitely handle. It doesn't have any retaliate. This is a really good target for us to send our critters after. So I think kind of the general game plan for this room is going to be to have the summoners go for this guy and the summons go for this guy. So what does that mean for us? I think what we're going to do to start is we're going to put the Mind Thief here. We'll put the Tyrant here. No, we're going to put the Tyrant. Actually, I think we're going to put the Tyrant here. So the Tyrant is going to take care of this guy. We're going to have our bear summoned here. The bear is going to, we're going to do an Earthen Spikes forceful swipe combo. So the Earthen Spikes, we can immobilize the guard captain. I don't know why I keep on saying he's the captain. I think it just, that's what I think he is. And a forceful swipe will push the guard away into this trap, which will do some damage. And combined with Immobilize will take him out of play for the rest of the round. It's a really great combo. I use it quite a bit. It's a common opener for me with the Tyrant when I'm playing with this build. With the Tinkerer, I think what we want to do is... Well, we could pull this guy into this trap, which would be pretty good. I think we might want to... that we might go ahead and do that. That might be the easiest thing, so we might actually switch the Tinkerer and the Mind Thief so that that can happen. So I think that we'll go for that. We can add a stun, possibly, if it looks like this thing is going to do something mean with our stun powder. And then with the Mind Thief, I want to go ahead and get a summon out. We're going to get a summon, and we're going to put him on this artillery. It's going to be, I think, we're going to go with the Gnawing Horde to start. So we want to go as slow as we possibly can with the Mind Thief. So that we don't have to worry about any of these monsters coming for us. If this gun fires at the Tinkerer, it's not the end of the world. The Tinkerer has quite a bit of health, and obviously quite a bit of healing capabilities. So I think that's how we're gonna play this. I think actually what we're going to do is we're going to also use Dark Frenzy, because that will generate some ice for use with Frozen Mind. Again, with this party, what we're really going to do is we're trying to crowd control these enemies as much as we can. Every turn to prevent damage from happening to ourselves and to our summons. So, Tinkerer, let's go ahead and do... We're going to do the hook gun. I think we can go... Actually, now that I think about it, this guy's going to be a problem. The bear's going to keep on attacking him. We need to toxic bolt him so that we can try to kill him as quickly as possible before the bear gets out over its skis and kills itself attacking this thing over and over again. So I think we're going to have the Tinkerer go for the Toxic Bolt instead. And maybe just go for the Murderous Contraption so that we can like really kill this thing quickly. Which means I think we're going to have the... we can still have the Mind Thief go slow, but we might move her back a little bit so that just in case there's something kind of mean coming from this here turret, this artillery, which could hit us pretty hard. So let's see how that goes. Worst comes to worst, the Mind Thief can always use her stun powder on this turret, and that will take it out of play for a turn. So I think this will work out okay. Let's go ahead, and maybe the Tinker will go. Well, we'll see what happens. Let's go ahead and put the bear here. Okay, so they're not doing anything super interesting. The artillery would hurt things that are next to it, but there's nothing next to it, so we're fine. The guard lead is doing a bog standard move and attack on the middlingest initiative that he can, so we don't have to worry about him doing any weird retaliating stuff. So I think we're going to go ahead and just not... We're going to pass on the initiative boots. No need to worry about that right now. Youch. Okay. So, Tyrant's up first. We'll execute the plan. Immobilize. Sneak some damage past this guard. And then we're going to go ahead and push this guard into the thing. Now, hopefully, this will actually get the bear closer to the cannon, the artillery, rather than the guard, so it will go after that rather than the guard, which is what we want the bear to do. We don't want the bear attacking this guard. So let's go ahead and push him into this trap. It's a she. It's a lady guard. I'm sorry, lady guard. I hear your voice now. So 4 HP left. We can deal with that. We can make that work. Let's go ahead and do a toxic bolt. Alright, well, I mean, that wasn't going to do any damage anyway, so that's actually a pretty good null for us to pull. And let's see if we can maybe get this thing close to dead. Not quite, but closer. Okay. Guard's going to go. Guard's not going to do anything because she is immobilized. Oh, look, they pulled the null too, so not bad, not bad. Okay. Let's go ahead and bring out our rat boys. Let's see if maybe we can. Like, I'm gonna continue just hitting this guard with range attacks as often as I can until maybe she dies. Mindthief has a better perk deck. Yep. So there we go. Dead guard. Good stuff. And we have our rat, which will be able to go after this here artillery next turn. Okay. So it looks like all we need to do here is just have the Mind Thief get a little bit closer and do some damage. And we can go ahead and stun with Frozen Mind. And that will take care of that turret for the round. We don't have to worry about what the turret's up to, which frees up the rest of the party to loot, heal, do other fun stuff. I think with the Tinkerer, we'll just go ahead and let's see. Is there anything that hasn't moved through? Let's go ahead and just move. We can throw on a heal. We should probably actually go heal sooner so that we can get to the bear before the bear moves too far away. And then we'll have the tyrant go, and I think I want the tyrant to just get closer, so we're gonna have the tyrant move. We don't have to really worry about it being a super fast move. And yeah, let's go ahead and use Unstoppable Beast. Let's get that consume that earth and get a little bit of extra damage on this artillery. I like that plan. Great. So we don't have to worry about initiative here. We're going to be faster than this turret. Right. So here's a kind of like a point that I want to make. People often say that summons don't scale, but that rat just stunned this turret and did two damage. The thing about summons is that they do scale. They scale like all your attacks do with your perk deck. And if you're attacking every turn with your perk deck with someone like the Mind Thief, that can be pretty darn great, because oftentimes the Mind Thief is only able to attack once a turn. So with one or two summons out, the Mind Thief can be attacking two or three times per turn, and with her perk deck, that can be pretty amazing. So that doesn't necessarily make up for not having the Mind's Weakness. And by the way, you may have noticed we don't have the Mind's Weakness. We also don't have Concentrated Rage on the Beast Tyrant. You can definitely get away with playing without those cards at a high level. You don't have to have them. It's perfectly possible, especially in digital, which is often a bit easier than the normal Gloomhaven campaign. Anyway, for that digression, I'm going to go ahead and move a little bit closer. I don't really even need Frozen Mind at this point because we've already been stunned, but we might as well just activate it for the lulls and for the XP. All right. So the Tinkerer will go ahead and heal the bear. And we'll collect some gold. Yoink. Artillery does nothing. Bear goes in. That poison is going to help us kill this thing even faster. Ooh, we could have healed ourselves. All right, so this thing is about to be dead, which is great. So Tyrant will go in. We'll command the bear. And okay, well, that again, like I said, very easy room. So here's what we got to do. We got to open up this door. We probably want to get this gold too. I would like to use the door trick on this door, I think, because we don't know what's on the other side. We can only do the door trick twice because we only have two invisibility cloaks between us, but we might as well get our money's worth with these. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to have the tyrant go in with the maul, and let's go ahead and use tyrannical force just to stun something in that room. This will keep the bear right here, so the bear won't really probably get targeted by any range enemies in that room, and it will let the mind thief and the tinkerer get closer without having to worry about any enemies, whacking them. I think with the Tinkerer, we're just going to go ahead and move just a little bit closer on the slow initiative, so we don't have to worry about anything in that room. Same thing with the Mind Thief. We just go in a little bit slower, and we're going to use Hostile Takeover, which will probably be able to hit something, generate some ice, get us so that we can start stunning stuff next round. So I'm feeling pretty good about this the situation we got here. No need for initiative changes. All right, let's see what's on the other side of this here door. Ooh, a bunch of artillery. A bunch of artillery surrounded by a bunch of traps, which is not great for our summoning guys. So this won't be able to. These things won't be able to attack anything because the line of sight can't. They can't see any of our dudes on the other side. So these guys are going to be completely at our mercy this turn, which is great. Let's go ahead and we'll skip the action. It's not going to do us any good. I would like to, I think, start working on killing this here artillery so that we can... I think we'll actually be able to push this artillery through these two traps, so... Or maybe we can pull through these two. Actually, it's probably the better option if we have the Tinkerer get a little bit closer. But I'm not sure if the Tinkerer can move that close that quickly. So I think what we're instead going to do is we're going to rely on the Bear's push again. We'll kill that thing. So let's actually do some damage to this guy, because that's the one that's going to need to be just hurt. Good stuff. Let's go invisible. Okay, and the ancient artillery are going to do nothing, because they can't see anybody on the other side. Oh, I probably should have gotten my push back with the Tyrant. Oops. Oh well, it's fine. Tinker is just going to move closer. That's all he can really do at this point. No point in doing the heal, because everyone is completely at full health, so... And the Plague Rock gets to move a little bit closer. All good. Okay, so the Mind Thief can, I think, go here and peer around this corner, yes, and hit that guy, which is good enough. That will be able to get us our ice for stunning, and that's what we want. Or maybe not. Maybe it's not gonna work. Okay, well... Lame. If I had known that was going to happen, I would have activated my boots. C'est la vie. I think we're just going to have to use our... we're just going to have to use the mana potion instead. Not ideal. I thought we would be able to hit that thing from here, but I guess it's hitting the door still or something, so... Oh well. So it goes. Okay. So we can easily stun everything in this room. No problem. I think what we're going to do is... not super easily. But what we're going to do is we're going to have this Mind Thief run in on quick initiative. We want to use, actually, I think the push... from Silent Scream, so we can kind of clear out this thing. And then we're just going to go ahead and use our long spear to push this guy, to attack this thing from a distance. Not the ideal use of a long spear, but still a pretty good use of it. The rat is probably not going to move because the tyrant is still there. Tyrant will go right after, and he will disarm everybody else that the Mind Thief was not able to stun. And that will take care of the room for the turn. I think with the Tinkerer... Tinkerer's just going to loot. Tinkerer's going to be a little bit greedy this turn. Sometimes you just got to be greedy with the Tinkerer. Get all that gold you can, man. Okay, what else do we got? Ancient. The Bear is not going to get in there either, so I think... no need to do any kind of fun stuff with the Bear. We could... We'll just move in. Okay, so we do the move and our push. We don't need to consume the ice because we want to use that for the stun on this guy over here. So skip the movement, but please yes to the push. Oh, and that kills it outright. Look at that. Okay, so we're going to use our long spear. We're going to use our augment to stun this one. Actually, we're not going to do that. Well, yeah, let's go ahead and do it. Why not? We're gonna need a long rest soon anyway, I think. So we'll get that long spear back soon enough. Nah. Pulling lots of nulls today. Okay. Tyrant is going to go in and we'll just go and disarm stuff and get some attacks on. Great. And the Tinkerer is just going to be a greedy little guy and grab this gold. He can be more useful in the next turn, I think. Alright, Tinkerer, let's move you in. And do I want to set up the auto turret? Why not, right? Yeah, we're going to have to use Stun Shot to get into the room, because otherwise we're not going to have enough movement to see anything. So let's go ahead and get the auto turret up. Yeah, the Mind Thief is going to go kind of slow, we don't even have any ice, but we can use Submissive Affliction to have one of these guys attack the other one, which is fun. Or we can just attack it. And then we're going to go slow with the Tyrant and maybe summon our Gator Boy. Okay. So this is probably the ideal time to for the Tinkerer to use his stun powder the first time, because we don't want this elite artillery to attack two of our guys. That's going to hurt pretty bad. So I think we're going to combine auto turret with the stun powder to do that. And that's one of the things I really love about the auto turret. Basically, as long as it's up and you have stun powder, you can just kind of stun anything you want. At any time. Okay. I think we're just gonna go. We're gonna see if we can just maybe kill this other turret before it can attack. Yeah, and we got a disarm. Ooh. Nicely done, Mr. or Mrs. Mind Thief. I'm sorry. Oh, why am I doing that? Let's get some experience. Great. And that guy's stunned, so excellent. Okay, and let's go ahead and get our gator out. That's gonna be fun, right? They call it a swamp lizard, but come on, it's a gator. I'm from Florida. This is a gator. Skip there. I had to stop and start the video, but we're back. Anyway, let's figure out what we're going to do. So we have a bunch of summons that are going to just completely wreck this artillery. We have a few rats that need to rest. I think I would like for the Mind Thief to long rest so that we can maintain control of what's in her hand. So that means I think the Tyrant's probably going to need to short rest, unless we have the Tinkerer short rest. Actually, I think maybe it's better for the Tinkerer to short rest, because the Tinkerer could just short rest and get his stun back. Stunshot back and deal with this turret, and then also get some loot. So sometimes it's best with the turret, with the Tinkerer, to just do a short rest before you even run out of cards. You don't have to run out of cards before you short rest. So let's do that. Okay. It's fine. So that means we can long rest with the Tyrant, too. So let's go ahead and do our stun shot. We'll move just a little bit closer. We don't need another summon out. I think two summons is probably good, or three summons with the rat is probably good for now. So yeah. Okay. Actually, I think we're going to have the Tinkerer move onto that loot so that the, we can get that loot later. Even if one of the bear or the gator covers it, it's fine. We can get it later. So we'll just go and not have to fire at disadvantage. Not that it's going to do a ton of damage anyway. Okay. Turret doesn't do anything. Oh, right, they get another attack. I forgot. Okay, now we can long rest, get rid of the cards we want to get rid of. I think we can get rid of... probably we need to keep some movement in our hand because this is a pretty big scenario. So let's go ahead and do... I guess let's get rid of the forceful swipe. And then we gotta figure out what we're gonna do with the Mindthief now. Mindthief, I think we can get rid of Vicious Blood. I'm mostly keeping Vicious Blood in the hand so that we can have that like that little move attack two in the bottom that lets us get a stun and also generate ice. But I'm not sure if we really need it like we do the other cards. We need the big move cards. So I think we're gonna get rid of Vicious Blood here. Okay, so now the question becomes who opens up the door? Always the fun question in Gloomhaven. We've already used up our Cloak of Invisibility on the Tyrant, and I think actually if we open up this door, we're still going to get, if there's a turret on the other side, it's going to hit the bear, and possibly even the Swamp Lizard as well. So it might just be kind of time for us to go in guns a-blazing and see if we can stun some stuff. So actually, I think I might have the Tinkerer be the one to open up the door. And we'll see what's on the other side. If the Tinkerer has to use up his other stun powder, so be it. But with these guys, shouldn't come too far behind. But if we go slow, then we can get in there without having to worry about taking too much damage. So let's go ahead and go slow. We'll let Tinkerer deal with whatever mess is on the other side of this door. Late sun's not the worst in the world. Let's just go ahead and do that. Alright, Tinkerer. Have fun! Woof. Well, that... Okay, so we have some friends on the other side here, which is actually good. Okay, so we have some friends. So actually, it's good for... it worked out for our Tinkerer to go in here first. The question is, who do we need to poison? Well, the Harrow Infestor is just going to heal the poison off, so that's nothing that we really need. I think probably we'll just go ahead and poison one of the city guards, because the city guards have no healing. They're not going to be able to do anything about that. Yeah, let's go ahead and maybe just poison this one so that this bandit guard can help us out, maybe get some damage in. Let's go ahead and attack the one in the back here that she won't be healing herself. All right, let's see these guys tear each other apart. Ooh, nice shot. Okay, well, great. Ah, poor bandit archer. Okay. Our friends are doing pretty good for themselves, I would say. Bear comes in. Think as long as the bears, maybe we really just don't want the bear to be attacking these pairs. That would be a mess. Can we get in? Oh man, it's getting a little thick with bodies over there, huh? Okay, well, I guess let's just get as far as we can and stun something. We could stun this one, I think. I don't really care if this one attacks this bandit guard. Just a smelly bandit guard. But I do want this bear to stay alive. Right, gets just a little bit closer. I don't even think this, like, Mindthief can really get in there. Well, okay, the Mindthief can get in there if we use the boots, which we should do, so that we can kind of, we can make something happen this turn. Harrow is going to retaliate for three, so if we use Silent Scream, we're going to get one of those health back, so it's not actually too bad for us if we do this. Always really lame when you miss on something that retaliates. It's a feel bad moment. Okay, we'll got quite a mess of enemies in here, don't we? I think with the Tyrant, we really wanted to get Ancient Ward out and hit something. So we're going to use Ancient Ward and Unstoppable Beast to kind of get into the middle of the room and disarm the two meanest looking enemies this turn. Tinkerer. So this is actually a great opportunity for the Tinkerer to use his Doomed Compass. That will let us push a group of these guys together, and then we can push this Harrower through here, and then we can immobilize them all, which is pretty fun. So I think that's what we're gonna do with the tank. Is there anything? I gotta be able to get closer, though, is kind of the problem. This is a really can I even like hit something? I'm not sure if I can actually make that plan work this turn, sadly. It might just be time for us to hit something. We might just have to kind of bide our time with the Tinkerer. Can I pull anything interesting or fun? Ah, I think I have a plan. Okay. We're going to pull. Let's see. Do we have. Yes. Okay. We're going to go fast. We're going to pull this harrower next to this guard. We're going to have the guard attack the harrower. But we need to do it slowly, I think, because otherwise the guard is stunned. It's annoying. Shoot. Okay. Well, I think we can still kind of work with that plan, though. We're just going to set up the Mind Thief so that we can have her do some funny stuff with these two. So, okay. Let's have the Tinkerer go as fast as he can. The Tinkerer is just going to hook gun. I think we'll still do the hook gun. Mind Thief will go just a bit slower than the Tinkerer. The Tinkerer will use his boots to go faster than the Mind Thief. The Mind Thief is going to use Submissive Affliction, and we're going to use Hostile Takeover. Still going very fast, but we're going to go slower than Tinkerer because of the boots. So, let's make it happen. Ooh. Actually, this works out great. Man, love Submissive Affliction. Okay, here we go. This is the Tinkerer, right? Ah, shoot, I screwed that up. Okay, gotta cheat a little bit. I sometimes click through just a little bit too fast, and I forget to use my my boots. It's a really easy thing to do in this game sometimes, so this is like a little slight cheat. I didn't even really see what the other enemies are doing, and we're going fast anyway. I'm not going to change any of the cards. We're just going to make sure that I actually click through the thing that I want to do. So let's continue to do everything as we did it before, but we're just going to actually use our item this time. Okay. Yes, Tinkerer, please go fast. Okay. Okay. Okay, so the main reason we want to go fast with the Tinkerer is I want to move this chump over here closer to that chump over there. And through the trap, too. And then we're just going to get Hook Gun. It's not going to do anything super great. It's just a range attack that we can use this turn. Because this is just such a thick a map thick with characters. So anyway, let's go ahead and what can I hit that will actually dang, everything's so shielded right now. It's no good. Oh, we were able to get through the shields. Skip it. And I can still heal some of our friends, but actually I'm just gonna be greedy again. Greedy Tinkerer is greedy. Let's hit the poison one again. Great. Okay. I want to stand for Submissive Affliction for a little bit. This is a highly underrated card. I don't know why more people don't love this card. It is fantastic, and it gets even better as you get higher level because your opponents get to have fun things like they have retaliate, like this thing has retaliate 2 innately. No, it has an innate retaliate 3, and it's also getting a retaliate 2 on top of that from its card. So this thing has got a retaliate 5 this turn, which means that if I have one of them attack another one, it's going to do a lot of damage. Like, we're going to have, you know, this guy could possibly punch through his shields and then also take a ton of retaliate damage. It's great. Love Submissive Affliction when there are retaliating enemies around. Also, things like Elite Wind Demons that disarm every time they attack something. Fantastic. Great card. You should use it as much as you can. It's great. So, let's go ahead and have this chump attack that chump. So we'll maybe get something through because of the poison. And then he's going to take a ton of damage because of the retaliate, which is great. Okay. And then they've already moved for the turn, so we don't really need to worry about them. The range of the mobilize is sort of something that's not really going to matter for anything, but I think we don't want to get our retaliate, so let's just go ahead and attack this archer. Ah, so many misses. Our friends do some more damage. Nice. I love it when the guards do the exact same thing to each other. Guard fight. Okay. Let's see. Let's go ahead and do the plan with Ancient Ward. What do I need to disarm? I think I need to disarm these two archers, right? I'm trying to think of, I mean, this one's just gonna attack this other archer. I don't really care about that archer. These two archers are gonna attack the Mind Thief. I don't want that. So I don't want that in my life. So let's go ahead and move this tyrant into position to deal some damage to these two. Nice work. All right, so that archer's having a bad day. Okay, well at least we have gnolls going all the way around. Nice. Okay, what to do this turn? The bear's gonna just go attack this thing. Might be good for us to move the bear out of the way though, so that if we can, do we even have a way? Yes, we do. So it might be good for us to move the bear out of the way so that the lizard can do something, but eh. Maybe we'll just go ahead and this actually might be a good turn for Monolith, so that the Monolith will just distract stuff. Yeah, let's just go ahead and get the monolith out. The monolith will keep all these guys distracted, and we don't have to really worry about what they're up to. Mind Thief can stun two dudes though, which is great. Not even so, maybe we don't need the monolith. Could still be good. And then a tinkerer. Is the tinkerer just going to be greedy? Is a greedy tinkerer just going to be greedy? Tinkerer could also disintegrate some guys, but I'm not sure if it's really needed at this point. So, I think greedy tinker gonna be greedy is what we're gonna do here. But maybe greedy tinker will be greedy slowly so that we can at least maybe heal something that takes some damage. Yeah, I think it's fine. Maybe no, let's go faster. So, yeah, let's go fast. Okay, so the guards are going pretty fast, but they're not going fast enough to beat. Oh, actually, we have a different move from the two guards. That's fun. Rat slowly waltzes up. Maybe that rat will be useful at some point this game. Oh, we can't quite get into position to get the double stun, so I'm gonna use my boots. Because I guess I didn't quite think that one through, but that's fine. We will use our moon earring to get our boots back. And we will move. Ah, because of the. It's still not gonna quite work because of that stupid dang. Oh wait, no, I forgot to activate the boots. Ha! Okay. All right, this will be good. Movements. Skip movements. Let's kill this harrower. Let's get a double stun with the spear, which is great. Love it. I mean, really, I just killed them. Okay, we killed the harrower. Like, yeah. Good job, Gator. Man, I don't even know if I really need to summon this monolith anymore. We could just kind of command. Let's just go ahead and command this bear forward and have some stuff up with the bear. That's fine. That archer we can deal with later. I want the bear to get further into the room while I still have the movement. Turns out I didn't need to worry about that stun, but hey, you know. Okay. Does the Tinkerer want to... Tinker can't even attack anything this turn, so Tinker is just gonna be greedy. Skip, skip. Now we can still attack with our auto turret. Okay, that was a spicy attack, but whatever. Okay, well, we can use either Earth and Spikes or Borrowed Essence, doesn't really matter which. They're kind of going to accomplish the same thing. Tinkerer is going to run in and maybe heal this bandit guard, why not? Because none of. I guess we can maybe. Nope, can't quite get to the tyrant. And I think with our Mind Thief, we are going to rest. Because the Mind Thief's had a pretty good day's work so far. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, so we need to... No, we don't want to cancel that. We want to cancel Frozen Mind. So let's go ahead and long rest. Okay. By mobilizing this archer, it's going to attack the bear at disadvantage, which is great. Which means I can start. Oh, wait, I can't loot because I am immobilized. Derp. Oh well. I could siphon some like HP off of this rat, which, yeah, why not? This rat. It's probably not going to be super useful this turn, the rest of the game, because it's so far behind, so might as well siphon some HP off of it. Cool. Alright, solid kill there from our Bandit Guard friends. Alright, we're in great shape. So, maybe let's go in. Oh, we could just heal up the rat again. Yeah. Alright, so the next few turns I think are going to be boring. We're just going to go around and collect some loot. Submissive Affliction is so fun. This is where the things get hard. I think I might as well get rid of Hostile Takeover. long rest with you. Might as well long rest with the Tinkerer. Okay. Mind Thief, we can start running around collecting some moolah. Anything good? Might as well just use move to. This is basically just gonna, I'm just gonna be running around collecting loot for the near future. This is gonna be a boring couple of turns for y'all to watch, but you know, sometimes you just gotta run around and collect some loot. We'll see if I regret this later, when I like run out of cards because I've spent too much time looting. Yes, I'm using my boots just for looting. Shut up. Alright, we're going to, I think... we can get rid of Borrowed Essence. And Tinkerer can get rid of Stamina Booster, I think. Maybe no, we're gonna use Hook Code for lots of loot. So let's just go ahead and throw away some cards to get in position for maximum looting with the Tinkerer. And we'll just loot with everybody else too. Could use Tyrannical Force to get stuff closer to the door. That might actually be a useful thing that the Beast Tyrant could do. Maybe I'll be good with the Beast Tyrant and do that. Killbot around for now. The killbot is definitely going to come out later, though. Okay, yeah, let's be good and move some of our summons up. But then we're going to get back to looting. Let's be real. I'm all about the loot. Tyrannical Force is a weird card, because I don't understand why it needed to be move minus one. I feel like it would have been a perfectly decent card without the move minus one. I don't really know why it needed that little nerf. Okay, so Tinkerer is going to go for the big loot. Mind Thief will just move around, collect some loot. Same thing goes for... Tyrant, we're just gonna loot. This is one of the nice things about playing a solo player. I don't have to compete with anybody for loot, I can just do it. Let's heal one of our friends. I don't even know if they're going to be helpful for us, but whatever. So I'll just activate. So yeah, I just activated Silent Scream for a free XP. That's it. Doop doop doo. Okay, I think we can just move a little bit closer. We're going to deactivate Silent Scream and long rest again, because all this looting has just really tuckered us out. Okay. As much as I love to stand for Submissive Affliction, I think it might be time for us to drop it. I'm not sure if we're going to have another opportunity like we did in this room to get a big retaliate. I don't really know how many enemies left there are left, so I might come to regret that. We'll see. But the Tinker can always give us that card back if we need it. Long rest with the Tyrant. We're in no rush. I think we'll just go ahead and have the Tinker open up the door. We will open it up, do a Toxic Bolt, see what happens. And the Mind Thief can go nice and slow. We've got our boots back because we rested, so we can kind of jump into the room if we need to. I think we're going to do the Silent Scream Rush creature so we can summon the rat if we have the opportunity. We'll find out. I'm gonna have the Tinkerer. Does the Tinkerer have his boots? Yeah, let's let the Tinker go fast, because then maybe we can get some use out of this archer. No need to move any of the other initiatives around. Okay. Let's hide in the back there. Oh, we have a golem. I think that golem's just gonna walk through that trap like a dummy. gotta love random level design sometimes. Okay. What do we got? We got a harrower that's just gonna heal itself. We got a archer that's gonna do some damage. I mean, I feel like we basically just gotta hit the harrower. The poison will at least prevent it from healing itself. That was kind of lame that we're gonna lose that poison so quickly. Interesting. Nah. Do I want a card back? Maybe it's a good time for us to stamina potion our stun potion back, because that will give us an extra turn. Okay. Let's see what the archer does. Nice. Okay, great. See? Good thing is to pay attention to initiative, and look at that boots gave us like 7 extra damage or whatever because that archer, so. Man, boots of speed. Don't sleep on the boots of speed, they're great. Ouch. Tinker is having a bad time. Unfortunately, that harrower is just kind of standing in a really awkward spot, so it's going to be kind of challenging for us to get into that room. And we've already blown the Tinkerer's... I think this might be time for the Tinkerer to use his Doomed Compass again to just move that stupid harrower out of the way. So let's go ahead and move closer, get our rat out, and hopefully we can do something with this. This stone golem is like, screw this, I don't want to get closer. Because the harrower is in the way. Yeah, this is a weird little situation we got in here. Okay. Heal, recover. I don't think we're going to get much use out of Stone Sigil. Stone Sigil is mostly used for borrowed essence. You can just put the monolith down and then just siphon it off to give yourself a bit of heal. But the bear's doing fine. We don't need the health. I don't think we really need Stone Sigil. Okay, once again, I think it's going to be Tinker going fast. We're going to have Mindthief go slow. And the Tyrant probably is going to need to go slow too, just so that we have some ability to like get in there. Hopefully we can use Earth and Spikes, but we'll find out. 2, 3, 4, 5. Not sure if we will. Maybe it's best for us to just... Yeah, whatever. I think we're going to just do Tyrannical Force. I'm okay with wasting that. Let's use our Empowering Talisman, get our Doomed Compass back, use our Doomed Compass on this stupid Harrower, get out of the damn way, Harrower. Okay, don't want to attack the Harrower because the Harrower is already gone this turn, and also, I mean, I don't want to get retaliated against. Got retaliate 3, that's no good. This golem is going to hurt if I move into the room, which I do want to do. The archer is going to... Oh, where's the... What are you doing? Archer is going to hurt less, but it'll mobilize, and I'm okay with that. So let's go ahead and just get into a situation where we can... stun the archer. Wow. Trick shot right there. Around the little kiosk or whatever. Ooh, Tinkerer's not having a good day. This rat's just gonna die. Oh well. You know, sometimes summons, that's what happens to them. We all know it. We can't protect our little summons forever. Sometimes they're just going to do some stupid stuff. Happens to the best of us. Okay. Well, let's at least get into the room and not attack the Harrower. I don't want to attack the Harrower again. Well, I might have to, though. Well, I'll just activate the thing. So, I mean, this Harrower is going to do 6 retaliate. That's pretty rough. Taking half damage, half my HP pool of damage just to attack it. I don't think I need to do that. I don't need that in my life. But I do want to activate Frozen Mind, so we're going to activate it, skip the attack, get an XP for it. You know, it's one of the only cards you can just do nothing and get an XP, which is pretty fun. Okay. Once again, this Harrower is just too much of a beast on retaliate this turn. I don't want to attack it. Okay. This turn, however, we can go pretty fast, and we can Ancient Ward, which will take most of these guys out of play for the turn, which is great. We can move into the room further, not have to worry about like chumming up this door. Tinker is definitely going to short rest. We want that stun back. Oh no, not my battle bot. No. Oh well. Let's go ahead and do disintegration beam. And let's. Can we get the murderous contraption out? Kind of want to get the murderous contraption out. But I think I have to be responsible and stun shot something again. Life of a Tinker can be boring sometimes. We'll use the murderous contraption for the attack. Let's see. Did I? No, I guess I've used up a lot of my I've used up a lot of cards with my rat. I should have really used my salmon potion a while ago. Like, would have been nice to do that. Oops. Okay. Well, if I discard Frozen Mind, we're just gonna have to short rest. Is what it is. We're gonna lose our Mind Thief a little bit early this game, but that's fine. I think we can carry this out with the rest of the squad, who are doing just fine. I guess the Tinkerer could like help out with Stamina Booster is gone, so well. It was nice to know you, Mind Thief. I mean, honestly, with all of our allies that were still alive, we could probably just open the door and let them slowly kill everything, and we'd still win the scenario. But let's have the Mind Thief go out on a high note. Well, we have one turn left for the Mind Thief, so let's get that out of the Mind Thief. Mind Thief can push this chump through a trap, though. That's kind of fun. Let's go ahead and do that. Why not? I could use Empathetic Assault to disarm this guy, but I don't really need to, so we'll hold on to that for now. I think we are just gonna go with the plan. So I would love to get on that loot pile, but I think the more responsible thing this turn will be to disarm everything. So we'll just get into the room and disarm everything we can get our loot on later. We want this stone golem to move towards us still, so the disarm is great rather than the stun, because then he'll just move through this trap and possibly kill himself. Yet another null. Okay, I think this is Golem's. Yep, Golem's gonna kill himself. So, Tinkerer can be his greedy little self. And he's disarmed. Yeah, let's go ahead and get our killbot out. Hell yeah. Get some loot, get a killbot. This is great. And let's heal ourselves. Silly golem. Didn't build you a very good brain, did it? Okay. I think we can basically kill this archer. Our summons are gotten kind of stuck in this big room. That happens with summons sometimes if you don't have a big move for them. Our tinkerer can go fast. And we can toxic bolt. We can do other things. Let's go ahead and just... Actually, let's just go ahead and go fast and heal ourselves and disarm it. And maybe the bot will do some damage. our Mind Thief needs to long rest so that we can go out on a high note in the next round. Maybe eventually this bear will get in here and do some something. Okay. And let's be greedy with our tyrant. I love I've gotten 80 gold this scenario. That's going to be good for shopping later. Yep, so that archer is D.E.D. dead. Don't even really, I mean, I could basically, I think I might just whack this archer, maybe see if I can kill him and get some loot. Kill her, rather. Yes. Whack. Man, the greediest tinkerer. Who says tinkerers don't make money? Okay, so I think basically our last turn is just going to be to run into the room, use an invisibility cloak, and hit something with empathetic assault. I think that's basically all this Mind Thief is going to be able to do, unfortunately. So let's go ahead and lose Frozen Mind, and that will be our last hurrah with the Mind Thief. I think we might go ahead and long rest with the Tyrant, see if we can have some control over hand. We'll go slow with the Tinkerer in case there's something mean in there, which there probably is. We can Toxic Bolt it. And our Mind Thief will go in and do her thing. Fast. Alright. Let's do it. Oh, okay. Just a few errors. That's no big deal. They're not even going to move, so... Okay. I mean, there's very little point in me. I mean, I can still go invisible here. That will still help the team, so let's go ahead and do that. Empathetic Assault. Might as well just... zap this guy. Didn't even use my stun powder with the Mind Thief. Well. Killbot might kill himself. No. Okay, good. Honestly, it's like, okay, this thing's going to do 5 retaliate, which sucks. But, I mean, we're at the end of the scenario. I think it's actually still worth it to get a Toxic Bolt on him. So, I think I'm going to do it. Like, you know, F it, man. Because if we get a Toxic Bolt on this Harrower, then that Killbot will be able to do a lot more. So, YOLO. Maybe should I Piercing Bow it just to get through the shield? I mean, why not, right? I mean, what else am I going to use the Piercing Bow for? Yeah, power pushing it. Why not? I mean, we're at the end of the scenario. Oh, we only had... So it was a range retaliate, I forgot. So that's actually... That wasn't bad. That was totally worth it. What do we want? I mean, Ancient Ward is one of the last cards I would ever want to lose. Tyrannical Force we could probably lose at this point. Oh no, the Mind Thief is exhausted. Okay. We're going to have our Tyrant move closer and see if we can get some disarms, which we should be able to do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're only going to be able to do immobilize. So maybe that's just what we're going to do. We'll just go with Earth and Spikes rather than Ancient Ward. We can use Ancient Ward next turn. Tinkerer is going to short rest. I mean, we're probably not going to get a whole lot more out of that, so that's probably fine. Okay. And we could Toxic Bolt something again. We could stun something. Stun's probably the wiser thing. We can do a disarm and a stun. That's a great use of the Tinkerer's turn, because now, now we don't even really need to do anything with, but whatever. It'll still do some damage. Okay. So here's another example of a time when it would be really good to use the boots. I don't know if it's going to allow me to use the Tinkerer's boots, though, sadly, because I think maybe I would have needed to use my Moon Earring before. Did I? Long rest, we'll find out. Nope. So, yeah. Unfortunately, we're going to get, that thing's going to get whacked pretty hard. Well, we'll just let the Tyrant take the damage, take the hit. That's fine. That's good. So this is kind of one of those things that you gotta do sometimes with your summons. It's just be a meat shield, put yourself in front of them so that you take the damage rather than them. If this were the board game, I would have been able to use the Tinkerer's Moon Earring to replenish his boots, and then I could have gotten out ahead of this Infestor. And that would have been great, but, you know, it is what it is. Well, you can't retaliate when you're dead. Okay. So now we've got the run out of place. We could basically just spend the rest of this game looting, and I'm kind of inclined to do that, because this guy is just going to keep wailing on this thing, so we might as well get some gold while we still can. So, well, we can disarm this guy. How much retaliate do you have? You have 5 retaliate. I don't want to attack you, so we're just going to move a little close. Well, let's stun ya. And what the hell? Let's disarm you too. Why not? You're definitely not going to be a problem next round. Okay, we're probably only going to be able to get one more turn of looting out of this this scenario, because that archer, that killbot, they're all going to wail on this guy real hard. So let's see if maybe we can at least get some XP, I think is what we want to do here. Ancient Ward will get the Tyrants and XP. We can move on to some loot. I think the Tinkerer can... Probably the best thing for the Tinkerer to do is just see if we can get some XP from Toxic Bolt. Ugh. Going fast, being a big retaliate. Oh, again, once again, you can't retaliate if you're dead. Doesn't mean that we're not going to be getting any XP, but hey, whatever. Yeah, sad. We had that Moon Earring, could have used it, would have saved us from some of those harrowers, but whatever. And get some loot with Tyrant too. Victory. That was a pretty easy scenario. And I thought our summons acquitted themselves pretty well. I mean, yes, they got stuck in the big room, but before they got stuck, they did some serious work. And I think all the summons, except for that second rat just died like a chump. And that happens sometimes. You win some, you lose some with summons. But overall, I think they did okay for themselves. Let's see. Tinker did a lot of damage, I think, with his kill bots and stuff. Tinker didn't do so hot on XP. Neither did the Tyrant. Mindthief, of course, being the Mindthief, did amazing with XP. But I think when you're at level 7, you don't care about XP as that much. It's like you're fine. So many items used, and obviously the Tinkerer, I gave that big loot too. So the Tinkerer was a champ, big looter. Okay. So I hope that watching me play that scenario helped people think through some of the tactics that you can use with melee summons in Gloomhaven. I mean, I think part of it's a state of mind. Like I said, like you gotta understand that your summons will fall behind. Your summons are gonna die like chumps sometimes. It happens. But like, if you keep in mind, like that gator, I think attacked like three, four, maybe even like five times. Like there's a lot of attacks from the gator. The killbot did some work. I think even the first rat did plenty of work in the first room. And so I mean, I think it's okay. I mean, like you just gotta take the good with the bad of the summons, and you gotta keep their weaknesses in mind. And it's usually just like it's good to think of it as like, you know what, this summon's gonna do some work in this room that I summoned it in, and if it does some work in the next room, that's a bonus. Is like the way I like to think about it. And obviously, if you have a lot of crowd control, stuns, disarms, immobilize, push, pull, these are all things that can help someone stay alive and get more hits in. And the more hits they get in, the more pulls you're getting from your modifier deck. And with certain modifier decks like the Beast Tyrants or the Mind Thieves, that could be a pretty big deal. Those are some great decks. So anyway, thanks for watching. I hope maybe folks enjoyed that. Let me know in the comments if you did, and if there's any other kind of weird builds or parties you'd like me to try out and make work. I'm happy to give it a shot. Until next time.